Okay. Are you Matthias?
Ah, it's just view and I'll do Fletcher.
Okay, so good evening. Months ago we did this quiz. So I will basically provide the answers and announce who basically have the best score on this. So 12 questions, 4 possible answers, pen and paper, and basically the results are the 1% of a resistor, the color is brown, so if you remember, I don't know if you remember your answers. Viva Blue, design suite is free, so you can program with FPGA with free tools. The fourth transistor here has to be used in a, like a RF thing, is T018. The ultra scale of the latest FPGA DSP slide is 48E2. Mr. Henry was the unit for inductance. The CR network is a high pass, not a low pass. The latest Xilinx FPGA is Spartan 7, and from what I've actually called Avinet, only available from this summer, so you have to wait for any development board. The putting capacitors in parallel, you end up with this ratio of 1 over C1 plus 1 over C2, etc. What's the coolest technology is obviously FPGA. the hot topic of IoT, because I think it was a special IoT that session. How many billions of IoT really no one knows? from what I've seen, I went to Sigfox launch on Friday, and they hope to have 1 million or 10 million devices, but wait and see what's happening. Interface coming up is iCube3, so this I think you have to quite look into this, because it's actually going to be really what it's going to take over in terms of interfacing for sensors and IoT. And then the Sigfox Shield from Unabiz is actually $65. However, the presentation on Friday was stating less than $25, so I'm going to start to inquire and see how come actually was $65 somewhere. So, results of the IoT. So, two people, one person called Chan, and the other one called Rudy G. Jen. So, are those two here?
No.
No? Okay. So, they have 10 points. The rest is pretty much 9 people have 9 points, etc. Et so, the price are basically 4 books plus some Blaze Pro wireless charger. So this one actually is something I was given in a sense. So this, if someone is interested into a tear down session or something later on, you can basically collect and play around. Inside is actually 2 big coils and some circuit that might be useful. I believe this one is actually working, probably working. A book which is probably not useful at all anymore, but it's an iPad developing 24 hours. I cannot say it's really true 24 hours, but in case you want some try iPad development. Raspberry Pi, the books, I really don't need it anymore. I think I'm not even sure if I've ever needed that book, but it's always useful if you give away a Raspberry Pi 1 to your kids or your nephew, etc. One book which I find actually, this one tells how old I am. I bought this book in 1990. This is a book that presents 350 schematics of amplifiers, oscillators, measurements. So this is really for, I think, Joyce or Royce, I don't know where he is today. He's not here, so maybe someone can pick up, or Hackerware can have this in store there. And then the book that I think everybody's probably want to have is hands on is this, I think the third edition is out now, so the second edition can be useful. So this book was, it was basically a library of the institute of where I work for, and basically they're closing the library, so I just picked up that book and someone. So none of the winners are here. So I need basically, let's say that this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then if someone come here, wants to have a first try, just pick up a number and then you basically get the prize. It's quite heavy, so I don't really want to carry that back home. The whole point is to get rid of it. So if you are lucky, you pick two. If you are unlucky, you pick the rest. But if someone is interested to get at least one prize, I think it is okay to... So anyone wants to come and have a try? Okay. You have to pick one. Okay. I think that the whole issue that, you know, if you don't really have a use of it, you can always put it into the hackerspace, because that's if people are really interested in.
I have a 10-year-old daughter I'm trying to teach.
Yeah. So. I think most of those amplifiers and emitters are probably illegal in Singapore. So I'm
later, after the
meeting.
Okay,
so let's go.
Thank you.
Okay.
Alright, so the next topic is...
So if some of you, I don't know if some of you actually have been to the quiz that one day answered,